Hello and welcome to another episode. Today's episode is extremely special. Today we are watching Indian Matchmaking, the reunion episode. And to watch this episode with me, we have a very special guest. So if you may please welcome the one and only Mr. Rohan Joshi.
Namaskar. Shadi, badhai ho. I have decided this whole video will be done in Bangala because why not? Also, Tanmay, congratulations. Actually, not congratulations, commiserations. Netflix made a better Honest Weddings than us.
God damn it. Damn it,
too
Netflix.
Too much honest happened in Netflix.
Not cool. Not cool, Reed Hastings. Okay, first of all, did you enjoy the show?
It was like watching like a very artful horror movie. like where the treatment is beautiful, but like the sinister message you're getting at the end is you're like, oh man, Sima's the serial killer, chalo Geeta bachayegi. Oh fuck, Geeta bhi serial killer.
It was like a car crash. Like you're not necessarily enjoying it, but you can't deny. You can't look away.
You can't look away.
Are your parents after you to get married?
No, actually my mom, it's been great, right? She's been watching the show after I recommended it and all. So I just keep getting these WhatsApps from her, like, what are parents these days? What do they want from these? And I can always tell which episode she's watching.
Alright, so let's start this episode.
Yeah, so I'm super duper excited about this episode because when I saw the ad for this, I'm like, it's like finding out there's an extra episode of Breaking Bad you didn't know. They're like, what? There's a whole episode I missed. That's amazing. Give me more.
I love it. So, immediately, I'm like, Dolly's earrings are fucking lollipops, dude.
Yeah, that. They're lollipops. That's so cool. Like, yeah, no. It's just like, I'm just worried that aisa lollipop dekke, like, will Akshay be able to answer a question?
I'm worried. Pradyum will want to marry Dolly now after this.
Yeah, you know, it's not nitrogen-filled lollipops. Dude, when he called Makhana Foxnut, I'm like, ye to South Bombay ke liye bhi bahut zyada ho gaya. Like, too much walking away from this, like, Foxnut.
Indian matchmaking. Love it, ya hate it, we all have binged it in one go. And the internet has so many questions.
I feel bad for everyone on this because they've been exposed to the level of judgment that I would not want anyone.
Oh, no, 100% not. 100%. This is, it's too much. Like, it's too much. It's already a bad situation, right?
Yeah,
when you're looking for somebody and you're being put through this arranged marriage thing. Now, it's on top of that. You know what? 40 million people are going to watch you do this.
No, 40 million people are going to watch an edited version.
8 episode mila ke, you maximum seen each person ka 30 minute ka footage, right?
Yes.
Of a process that was probably months and months long.
Yeah.
When Pradyuman brings that those nitrogen fox nuts or whatever. Cute, mom is just enjoying smoke and this.
No, flatulent makhanas.
The flatulent makhanas. And mom is just sort of enjoying it. But the way they hold that sort of shot on her.
Yeah.
As if to sort of be like, what is this shit? Like,
look at this,
like,
crazy people.
Let her enjoy it. Forget nitrogen. If I go to a cold place and vapor comes out of my mouth.
Yeah.
For 5 minutes, I'm like. look. I don't know, man.
Yeah, and you know, when they cut to Pradyuman's closet and all his own photos are... Okay, no, that's just weird. Sorry, never mind.
No.
He just acted like, you know, this whole like, oh, you have to spend your whole life, you have to be picky. I'm like, tereko bas hot bandi chahiye thi. That's all you wanted.
Basically, Pradyuman, for 8 episodes, not get out the sentence, is like, mereko babe chahiye.
Was there any incident, any message that you got that really overwhelmed you?
Yeah, I've actually gotten quite a few from women who are in relationships that they want to leave or proposal situations where they're just not comfortable.
So I have to confess about Aparna. I reacted to the first 2 episodes where I was making jokes. Ki what is happening? Especially Aparna's mom who was like, oh, this guy is a loser and all this stuff.
That was damn hardcore.
That was damn hardcore.
That was damn hardcore.
Yeah.
Like,
and later on, when I watched the rest of the show, she does open up a little bit and you know, you see another side.
Absolutely.
And later on, I was like, actually, I really like her. She just knows what she wants. And that's
she
the
does.
Good thing.
What Aparna needs to learn is that usko shaadi nahi karni hai.
Yeah.
She's so at peace with herself and who she is and what she's got going on in her life.
Yeah.
That actually, abhi is waqt uske life mein jagah nahi hai partner ke liye.
Correct.
Because I'm reading my DMs sometimes with tears in my eyes.
That's a lie. There are no tears.
There are no tears. Why would you cry more than 3 tears? What's wrong with you?
Yeah. Your glands are losers.
But on a scale of 1 to 10, how much do you hate comedy?
Bad comedy? A lot. That's the thing. It's very hard to find really good comedy. I've found it a lot through this Indian matchmaking process. People's memes are cracking me up. There's a lot of bloggers that are doing some really creative videos.
Oh my god, that might have been me.
Yes. Congratulations, Tanmay. Oh my god, I am not loser. You are not loser. You are win number one.
But to be fair, I have podcast also. So her mom will probably reject it.
Just don't take her axe throwing.
Are you ready to see the most fakest laugh in the world?
So I don't think that I'm opposed to humor, but I just think that overall a lot of people are not funny. And they think they are, and they're not.
Mommy, act!
I still talk to Dilip every day. I talk to Shaker every day. So the men I went on dates with are who I really call my friends today.
Oh my god, she's filled up the space for a partner with three friends.
With three friends.
Who are all texting every day.
Also now, yeah. That he's like, in the case of like the Shaker, Dilip, etc., all of them, they now have this common experience also, right?
Correct.
So it must be a blast to actually just talk about what that. I'm sure there's a WhatsApp group where just email and DM screenshots are shared.
Yeah, you know what the WhatsApp group is called? Loser!
Okay, so Aparna, we see that there's a pattern in the show where the men and women are treated kind of differently when they reject a proposal or take their time with it. Women, even if they would reject one rishta, they would be called stubborn and too picky and not flexible enough. Do you have something to say about that?
I can't speak for the culture and the society as a whole. I can speak for Sima. That's who I worked with. And so to watch her with Pradhuman, tell him, it's okay that you've seen 150 girls. Here's some chocolates that I'm going to bring you. And then to watch her with me, where she says, you're negative, you're stubborn, very strange and very concerning. And that actually gave me a little pause about, you know, the process and how this was going to look for me.
That's fair, actually.
That's 100% fair. I have absolutely no argument or complaint with anything being said here. With Pradhuman also, like, ek aisa nitrogen dala Fox Nuts mein. Uske baad Sima 10 episode ke liye. But Pradhuman, you're so creative. You need to all, yaar. Versus you reject two people and say that fortune teller says, na, ye jiddi hai aur hatti hai.
She want to do what she feel like doing.
She's hatti.
She is loser.
When that one contributor, I think his name is Vinny, he apparently, allegedly, didn't show up or something.
Yeah, this Vinny, how do you make
Vinny's excuses were damn shady. I'm arguing with my sister. What does that mean?
Yeah, it's bullshit. Who cancels then? You cancel 10 minutes before the other person leaves. Till there, it's like forgivable. Okay, you didn't waste my time entirely. Right. He gave two excuses, yeah, right? One was arguing with sister and the one before
and
that
one was he got dehydrated and he
had which is like, just any bullshit.
He may not be a man of many words, but I hope he has a lot to say today. Meet Akshay.
Alright, it's Akshay time.
I'll just get my mom to review this segment. Wait.
What's your opinion though? How do you feel?
I really like the show. I mean, there was nothing wrong with it. It was pretty good. Obviously, it was a bit cringy. That's why people have, you know, stormed the internet with it. Yeah, it was a fun show, man.
Okay.
You know, I bet he didn't know the word cringy existed before.
Until the show. Yeah. He has also already said more in these last 40 seconds than he said on the whole show.
Yeah. Akshay seems like the guy who first thought the word was cringy. And then he was told that.
So going forward, there was obviously your engagement that we saw happening, but we also heard that it broke off. The engagement is no more there with Radhika. Are you comfortable telling us what happened?
Oh yeah, of course, I'm totally comfortable. So what happened was,
she was not my mom.
What happened was, I woke up the next morning and realized
that Mummy is this side and Radhika is that side, which meant they're not same person. And I was like, something is weird.
I'm just like, what is going on with my life? What am I supposed to do? You know, I can't even hold a conversation with this girl for 5 minutes. So how am I supposed to spend the rest of my life with this girl? And that just kept going on in my head again and again and again. Is it that we are completely two different people? Everything's just opposite. I can't see myself.
He basically is questioning arranged marriage.
Yes, he has basically, right now, what happened is Akshay did the classic male trope of like meeting someone and then getting intense commitment phobia.
Yeah, yeah.
Intense. Literally, he went home and raat ko gaand pad gayi. Main kya kar raha hu?
Kya kar raha hu?
Since the day I opened up and I told my parents about it, it's like a whole burden coming out of me. I feel so free. It's so good. You know, it feels just really nice.
He does though.
Okay. Yeah, he's all of a
sudden. He looks like a different person.
Dude, it took a fucking $50 billion company to do a show about you for you to have one conversation with your parents, dude. Like,
wild, right?
Yeah.
Wild.
It's crazy.
And she's pretty normal now. I'm telling you, the day after I told her and everything happened, she's like, Mom, I'm not happy. Then why to do this and all? And she's like, okay, beta, your happiness is our happiness. If you're happy, we are happy with whoever you are. And there's no, if she's...
I call bullshit.
Cool too, you know?
Yeah,
I call hard bullshit on this.
I feel if we cut a little wider, there's three rifles pointing at him right from the side.
And she's holding all three.
Yeah. Like, I have shot these shows, right? And I've seen how it's done in the hunt for content. Sometimes you're like, okay, just talk about, you know, cook something. Just talk about how, you know, how would you feel if there was...
That's fine. No, I even agree with that, the whole reasoning of all of that. But how do you explain to me they cannot have a baby because you are not getting married? Like, try walking that sentence back. Like, I beg you.
I also think there's a certain amount of enjoyment in people criticizing every statement made by every participant on the show, saying it's very fun to extract the very worst meaning that can
absolutely
be taken
true
out of
absolutely
everything
true
that everyone has said.
When Radhika made it clear that she wants to work, and right after we had a clip of you saying that I want my wife, future wife, to be at home and taking care of the kids. What about that?
So before, when she asked me, I was like, yeah, man, that's completely fine. If you want to work, it doesn't have to be extreme. There has to be balance in life. I mean, work also, what about kids? Because I know what I'm supposed to do. She never asked me, you know, how are you going to take care of the kids? If she would have asked, I would have probably told her.
But let me ask you that question then. How will you take care of the kids, Akshay?
To me?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I really don't know. Really.
That was such a self goal.
Yeah.
What a self goal.
Yeah,
oh my god.
Me? Just now you said. Just now you spoke about it.
Mummy!
Look at his face right now. That's when he knew he fucked up.
I thought I calculated, but man, am I bad at math.
Whatever they do, help her in the night. I know when usually kids wake up at late in the night, take care of them, start if they start crying, take care of them, grow them up, you know. I mean, that's how I'm gonna...
I feel like he's one step away from saying, I'll put fertilizer, I'll water them, I'll take them for walks.
My favorite is, I'll make sure they grow up.
I'll make sure
they grow up. Okay, Akshay, you have not made sure you grew up yet. I'm just saying, man. No offense.
Nadia, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
But have there been any DMs or any, I mean, I should say thirsty DMs as well? Because I think we all fell in love with you, men, women, everyone.
I've gotten proposals, I've gotten people, you know, saying, let me take you on a date, let's have a FaceTime, I'll treat you right.
Yeah. Wo tere liye sahi nahi tha. Main tere liye sahi rahunga, Nadia. Main sach bata raha hu. Yeah.
I'll treat you right. I'll treat you good.
And I'm sure men have said things like, I don't even have sister to argue with. I drink water every day. I drink lots of water, no dehydration. I'll come to any bar.
I have been to Papua New Guinea where I know you come from. Like, nobody.
This episode where Nadia broke down and she was very upset about you ghosting her. When you watched that, what were your thoughts?
I mean, obviously, when I'm watching that episode, like, it upset me a lot because... to see like the reaction amongst like especially amongst the female audience like that I was getting was kind of like hurtful, because there's obviously two sides to every single story, and I definitely made some mistakes, but I'll own up to any single mistake I make. So never just necessarily try to judge a book without by its cover.
I love that Vinay's entire response to this is, you know what, I fucked up my chances with the chicks, man. Like, you know, female audience. That's his whole takeaway from this.
But I feel like your dating life must be in so much peril after this, right? Like, every time he goes on a date, he has to show up 30 minutes before now and send proof that he is at the restaurant.
Hydrate a lot. Right?
Because
constantly peeing during the date.
No one who's gonna show up on a date is gonna believe that he's gonna show up now. He's like, oh fuck, he's gonna pull off an Nadia now.
I think the fox nuts that you made, the peri peri fox nuts, were
a big hit. They are a big hit. Did you ever think that they're going to be so huge online that people are going to pick on that?
It's gone to another level. Like, people have trolled it to another level. I'm like, guys, no one had fox nuts before, or what was it like?
It's called Makana! What is wrong with you?
But I think it's nice.
I just want to apologize on behalf of South Bombay.
But also, there have been a lot of comments about your lifestyle and, you know, the portrayal that has been on camera and everything. Do you have anything to say about that?
Guys, I think I am as a common person as everyone over here. I
with my liquid nitrogen fox nuts and freaking Volvo sedan, yeah, and this ginormous house with a fingerprint lock
with
and
every,
just a normal...
Every moment I've ever shared with anyone that's been captured in a picture and plastered all over my wall.
I'm
please.
The same. I like mammals. I like sea life. I'm normal, guys.
I don't eat fancy food every day. I have pretty much my paneer every day. I'm just another regular...
God. This introduction has been a disaster.
This is the embodiment of paneer samosa kaacha. This is the fact of my fact now. Oh my god.
You went on a very good and nice date with Roshali. I think we all saw you all kind of bonded, and I think from the previous date that was a big difference. So that went with Roshali went great. What happened after that, if you're comfortable telling us?
But later both of us realized that, okay, you know, we are at different stages in our life. She was looking out for a modeling career. I was looking down to...
For a model.
Sima aunty said that you have been quite, like you've rejected over 150 bio datas.
Oh my god, Rohan! I just realized, he is Vicky
what?
Malhotra.
Oh, he is Vicky Malhotra!
Yeah!
Oh,
I just realized!
Vicky.
Yeah, rejected 150 girls. He's...
Like, this is like some horror movie in which Varun's Snapchat filter has come to life.
When you presented a bio data, a normal sense, it's like, are you interested or you're not interested? Very similar to how we open a dating app, right? There's so many girls, let's say, that have been presented on the date.
I agree with him 150%.
100%.
You are left 100%. Swiping on just
yeah,
a bunch on a bunch of text. Okay, 100%. I'm not 100%. Interested. Move on.
But in the show, initially you mentioned that good looks are really important for you, that, you know, you should be attractive. Has that changed in any way, or is that still the same?
See, good looks is the first form of attraction. And then it is definitely... the mental attraction, which becomes the main form of attraction.
See, good looks is first form of attraction. Then there is mental attraction. And together they form babe. Okay?
Yes. No, that's not. Together they form good looks. That's it.
The first attraction for anything is always a physical attraction. And there is a mental attraction. But the mental attraction forms the basis of holding the whole attraction portfolio together.
Attraction portfolio. We have reached peak Guju Madu. It's we're done. We're attraction portfolio. I don't know what to say. Attraction portfolio.
I can't.
I'm sure it's handled. He's not. So Sima Taparia is not a matchmaker. She's a relationship manager. Of the attraction portfolio.
I don't know how to respond to this.
I don't even know.
Have you ever seen someone trip while talking but not moving at all? He has fallen down. His whole store has collapsed while he was trying to make through this sentence.
I'm willing to bet that it's been edited out, but at some point in this conversation, Pradyum tried to sell Dolly Diamond.
Okay, next up is the man we all loved as soon as he chair rolled into our lives.
Love this guy. No comment.
Vyasar!
1,000,000% love this dude.
I love Vyasar.
Hi Vyasar, how are you?
I am doing very well. Thanks for asking.
We saw you tweeting about your DMs that are coming in, flooding in, I would rather say. Are there any DMs that in particular really surprised you?
It's a kind of creepy thing to message someone you don't know. So they try to use comedy to lighten how they slide in. With girls, overwhelmingly, girls are trying to, you can tell that they're trying to like make it quick and fast. Like, hi, I think you're really cute, bye. Or like, hi, I saw you on the Netflix show, you're cute, bye. And they're just, it's like, they like, if they say it fast enough, I won't notice it, or I won't notice how pretty it is. Which is cute. And with lots of people who feel really empowered by what I was sharing about my father and feel like, you know, they can open up to me and talk to me about their stories and everything. It's really nice to see that. I'm not going to respond, but it's still really nice.
Yeah, obviously, definitely. That was, I think, one of the...
I love how expressive he is.
He's so expressive. Yeah. He's one of those people. He and Ankita were the two people on the show where you watch them immediately and you're like, tum log is chakra mein kaise
gaye? Kaise ghus gaye? Kya kar rahe tum
log yahan pe? You do not belong here. Run for your life. You guys have too much personality to need a Sima to find someone for you.
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah. It's great for someone who can't tell what looks good on them or not.
Exactly.
One of the people who sent me a DM was this young Pakistani guy whose family had been watching the show across the world. His family is scattered all over the world. They were watching the show together, and they were having like a big video chat after the end of the show with all of the cousins to talk about it. And he said it would be really great if you just dropped in and said hi in the middle of our conversation. And so I did.
Of course he did. Because Vyasa is the kind of guy who'd do that.
That's not, man. I'm like, yaar, Vyasa, tu dunya chhod de, mujhse shaadi kar,
yaar. So sweet.
That's brilliant.
Vyasa, you're too pure for this show. Vyasa, you're too pure for this show. You don't belong here. I have this intense urge to save you from this show. Like
it's he's like the antidote to Sima Taparia. Like,
yeah. He's the antidote to Akshay. He's the antidote to Sima Taparia. Yeah. He's the antidote to all of them.
Yeah, if the doctor said, aapko Sima Taparia hua hai, din mein do baar Vyasar lijiye. That's what a doctor
exactly.
would say.
Yes.
Ankita,
she's the best.
How are you? How's it going? And I'm
she was
so
cool.
glad I met
you. I'm just going with the flow. Like, how I was told in the show to go with the flow. That's exactly what's happening to me right now.
Was there anything in particular you saw? Because there are so many memes and tweets and everything that is going on around the show. Was there something that really caught your eye or made you emotional?
I received a message on my WhatsApp from an unknown number, and I was really surprised because the first line said Indian Matchmaking, and I had no idea how a stranger has my number on their phone. I opened my WhatsApp and I see that the girl had written, "Hi Ankita, I saw you on Indian Matchmaking, and you might not remember me, but 3 years ago you and I bumped into each other at Eye Candy in the washroom, and I was crying and I wanted to end my life that night. You took me out, you made me have a drink, and then you force fed your number into my phone." And this particular girl still remembered me from that 3 years ago, man. And for me, it was everything.
Okay, Ankita, I think that was really beautiful. I almost got teary-eyed. Thank you for sharing that with us.
There was no funny response to this. That's amazing.
Yeah, but she saved her life, dude. That's crazy.
Yeah, that's wild.
What is she doing on this show?
Really, what is she doing? Like the question Dolly should have asked her was like, how do you feel when you realize Geeta was also a goddamn snake?
Okay, but are you still in touch with Sima Aunty?
Sima Aunty and I just happened to talk 2 or 3 days ago, and my friend and I had planned a small live session for her because we were like, too much hate she's getting. Like, you know, let's just like see who she is as a person. So we had a small live session with my friend for her, and she felt great after the session, and she called me up to say that, thank you so much. I wish you'd made me meet this girl earlier. Her smile is like sunshine. And yeah, that was it. And then yeah, Sima Aunty and I realized we both practice Buddhism. So we were just like chit-chatting about that. And that was it.
Ankita is so wholesome.
Yeah.
So wholesome.
Yeah.
That she saved Sima
Aunty. Yeah.
On this show.
Yeah.
Sima Aunty. Wow.
I really respect her for that. For her to recognize that Sima Aunty is getting so much hate.
She should probably
reach out. And I think
there's a degree of empathy there that's just so nice. Right?
Yeah, that's great. I love Ankita. Alright, Joshi, how do you feel?
I'm kind of nervous and I'm really hoping it works out. Between us. I mean, I don't know how the date's gonna go, but I'm kind of excited. This is actually just such a complicated show to unpack because, fuck it, this says so much about us culturally.
Yeah.
Overall, I think what I'm taking away from this is that the people who were on the show at least seem to be in a good place.
Yeah.
After such an overwhelming experience. So, touch wood for that, right? And I think that's mainly it. And also just like, please say Makana, not Foxnut.
I think all of us saw Indian Matchmaking and we all went through our first core instinct, which is to judge everybody on it. And I think watching this episode will make you empathize with a lot of those people. But also clarify a lot of the stuff that they did that made you feel like, you know, you don't like them.
And for the most wholesome people out there, they're as silly as it sounds, I was so invested in the show. I just sleep better at night tonight knowing that they got me.
Yeah.
Like, Right? Yeah. Nothing but confidence. They got this. Yeah. And that's a good feeling.
That's a good feeling. So highly recommended. Do check out the episode. It is on the Netflix India YouTube channel. On that note, Rohan Joshi.
Tanmay. But is your BP normal?
My BP is. I'll just check. I'll just come back.
Just check.
Yeah. Just check. Can you give him Foxnut, Naveed? Thank you.